Mr. Godoy. It's very easy to pronounce, like Go and then Doy, Godoy. All right, let me have you guys introduce yourselves.
Angelina.
All right. I'm going to talk to you about a book today that was written and illustrated by a man named Maury Sendak. And the reason why I want to go over the book with you is because I want you to see how plot can affect the storyline or the narration of a book. All right. So I'm going to talk to you about this book, and I'm going to be talking the most, and so that I can make sure that I don't talk too much. I'm going to time myself because I have a feeling I have a tendency to talk a lot, if you let me. So I'm going to start it, and then I'm going to ask you some questions throughout. And when I go over the second book, I'm going to ask you the most questions, all right? So this is called Where the Wild Things Are, and it was written and illustrated by Maury Sendak. All right. So it starts off with the main character, Max. And Max is... What does he look like? Tell me what he looks like from this picture.
He looks like he's like a little crazy.
He's
like a tent in the wall.
Tent in the wall.
And he looks like he has a costume. I think he's like imagining, playing with his imagination.
Okay. All right. So he's playing dress up. Yes.
I bet he tried to act like a wild animal.
Yeah, it's kind of like a wolf. Actually, he's got like a little bit of a wolf costume.
He has a big old hammer, a tiny tail.
Yeah. So in the story, Max is tormenting his family. You can see him right here tormenting the family dog, chasing the dog. The dog does not look happy in this picture.
I feel bad for the dog.
Yeah, I feel bad for the dog too. I mean, he's...
Now we're not
the dog thinks he's going to get eaten.
Yes. All right. So Max, actually, he's doing so poorly. Max is not doing well in the beginning of the book. He is being a little bit difficult, kind of a lot difficult. And he gets sent to his room without dinner, so you know he's in trouble. So his behavior and the way he wants to act is not working well in the house. And so Max goes to his room, but then something happens. Trees start growing in his room.
That's not normal.
And let me step back a bit. In the first part of the story, when we first meet Max, what is the setting? So we're going to talk about the setting.
His house.
The setting is his house. And then when he gets sent to his room, when things start changing, trees start growing, and pretty soon they start taking over his room, and then pretty soon he's definitely someplace different.
He's in a forest.
And then he gets into a boat that he finds on the edge of the forest and sails across the ocean. And there are monsters in the ocean.
That looks wild.
It's pretty crazy. And then he comes across an island of where the wild things are. And he actually, instead of being afraid of the monsters, he's actually in control of the monsters. All right? And you can see that Max gets crowned. All right? So he's the king of the wild things. And there's all kinds of wild things. And when they get together, they have a lot of fun. And this is Max fun. This is Max's type of fun. Just like it was, this is the kind of fun he's been looking for in his house. When he was trying to have fun chasing that dog, when he was trying to have fun taking that hammer and nailing it into the wall, nailing his tent into the wall, that's the kind of fun that Max wants to have. That's the kind of fun his mom was not very happy with. All right? But Max was having all of his fun in where the wild things are. He is swinging in trees, he is in charge, and everybody's listening to him. Whatever Max says goes. You can see that. They are doing exactly what he wants. But is Max happy?
No.
He's frowning. So Max wasn't happy in the beginning of the book, and he's not happy when he's gotten what he's wanted, to be someplace where he can be wild, like he wanted to be in his house. So he decides to return to his house. And he decides sail back home in that boat. And when he gets home, his mom has left his food in his bedroom, and it's still warm. So the first setting of the book was
his house.
And the second setting of this book, the second setting of the book is Where the Wild Things Are.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Where the Wild Things Are, was that real or imaginary?
Real.
Raise your hand if you, what you think.
Imaginary.
Yeah. What makes you think that it was imaginary? Raise your hand if you want to tell me what it is.
Both.
Both? Both real and imaginary?
Mm-hmm.
Because, why? Or, let me tell you what, discuss it among your table, with your people at your table, if it, you think that in this case, it was imaginary or real, and then I want to hear from the tables once you discuss that. This story, I want you to see it again, where when Max's room starts changing. It starts changing gradually. And it wasn't as though Max walked out of his room and went someplace different. It became a jungle. So talk among your table mates and tell me you think Max is as real or imaginary. And when you're ready, thumbs up.
I think it was imaginary.
Y'all agree?
If it was real, he would have just walked out of his house and then went to a jungle or a forest.
Yeah, so he didn't actually go anywhere. He didn't actually leave where he was. It came to him. That's why he feels more natural. But there were two settings. There was the very real setting of him being in his house, and then there was an imaginary setting that of
Where the Wild Things Are.
Yeah. So, so there are two settings, and what was Max's problem at the beginning of the story?
He wasn't having that much fun.
Because he wasn't, and because
his
mom wasn't letting him have fun because he wasn't behaving, and so that was a problem. What was the solution? What did he learn on that imaginary island?
Because if he didn't put a line on this area, he wouldn't have learned.
He wouldn't have learned what? Couldn't be wild. Being wild doesn't serve him very well, so he realized that he would rather follow rules than be wild. Because if he was wild on the island, he wouldn't have been able to take care of him. All right. So that is the way that the plot changes this story. Okay. Now I'm going to go over another story with you, and let me try and make that kind of. All right. So this one is Zathura. All right. And you're going to notice there's some similarities between Zathura and Where the Wild Things Are, all right? So Zathura is a space fantasy story by Chris Van Allen. And like I said, we're going to see what similarities we can find with Zathura and Where the Wild Things Are, all right? So I'm going to go over this and ask you just a couple of questions, and we're going to kind of compare the two books and see what are the differences and similarities. So I want you to really pay attention. So the first part of the story starts off with a story of two brothers. And the two brothers do not get along. The older brother's name, Walter. The little brother's name, Danny. Now Walter thinks that Danny is too much of a baby to play with him or spend time with him.
Mm-hmm.
And because he's complaining to his mom that Danny broke his walkie-talkie. When they were wrestling over it, Danny got his nose bruised, so he's kind of upset. And his mom is telling him, I want you two to behave because we're going to leave you alone in the house for a while. And so Danny still wants to play. Walter still does not. So he gets a ball, and he accidentally hits Walter. And so they run out to the front yard, and they start wrestling. All right, let me backtrack one step and ask you, based on this picture and this picture, where are they? What is the setting? They're at their house. They're inside the house in the beginning of this, in the first page, and they're in the front yard. What is it? What?
That.
This right here? this is, well, I'm gonna tell you right now. When they're wrestling outside, Danny finds a board game, and it is called Jumanji, but this is specifically Jumanji Game of Zathura, all right? And so he brings it inside, because this is something different that he's never seen before in their front yard, and he starts playing with it, and he starts working. And it's this really really interesting, complicated, mechanical board game. He turns a switch, and a card pops up, and the card says, gives him all the directions, and it says, a meteor shower will take place in your house. And then a meteor shoots through the roof and hits the television set. And the boys are very confused because they're like, what happened? And so they want to go investigate. They want to go outside and look at the front of the house. When they go outside the front of the house, they notice something has changed. It's dark outside and they are no longer, their front yard is no longer there. How has the setting changed?
They're in space now.
So we have a setting change. So we need to see if this setting change is going to change what happens in the story. Walter pulls his card, and it says, you've turned off gravity. Walter goes up to the ceiling. But Walter starts to edge towards that hole in the ceiling. To save him, Danny throws up the cord from the lamp, and Walter's able to tie it around his leg so he does not go sliding out of the house and into space. And then it is Danny's turn to pull a card, and it says, your robot is malfunctioning. And the robot comes towards them, and he knocks over when he tries to enter the room, but his goal is to hurt he thinks they're alien life forms, so he keeps on repeating, must kill intruders, so their lives are in danger. Just when that happens, Danny decides that he has to pull another card to move things along. He pulls a card, and it says that gravity has increased. And Danny becomes gravity starts to increase on Danny, and he gets very round and very wide and very heavy. And Danny has the great idea to have Walter roll him over onto the robot, and he does. And he's able to disable the robot, and he flips the switch on the robot. All right. So who had a very good idea here?
Danny
had a very good idea.
Two times.
First was the lamp, and the second time was to get him to roll over. So then Walter rolls again, and it says, your spaceship is being boarded by alien invaders. And this makes him very nervous. And so what they see is a lizard-like alien coming on board their house, and very quickly and very smart, and a very smart decision, Danny decides to flip him. Oh, that means I need to speed up a little bit. All right. So Danny decides to flip the robot switch on, and now the robot is behaving right, and he knows that Danny and Walter are not the aliens, but he knows who the real alien invader is, and he goes and protects the boys. He does what he's supposed to do. He's no longer malfunctioning. And Walter pulls another card, and it says, you are being sucked into a black hole. And immediately, a black hole starts to cover him up, and he finds himself back where the story started, in the front yard, wrestling with his brother, exactly in the same spot. And then he kind of jumps off from wrestling with his brother, and his little brother notices the board game next to the tree, and he says, do you want to play that game? And he said, no, I think I'd rather play catch with you. And he puts his arms around his brother and takes him to go play catch with him in the park. All right? So let me ask you some questions about this book. What were the two settings in this book? What was the problem at the beginning of the book?
Danny and Walter were not getting along.
All right. What changed when they went into their second setting? What changed about what changed to help them solve their problem? What changed to help them solve? I want you to tell me about. Talk to your friends. if you need to. Let me give you about one minute to talk to your friends. Tell me what changed in the story to solve that problem at the beginning. Talk with everybody, then I'm gonna ask them randomly.
They
started
working together. Wow, Danny's actually doing that. You see, Danny, I should have. All right.
Thank you. Can you answer now? Why was the little brother valuable?
Because when the percentage changed, they stopped fighting and they realized that they need to work together to solve this whole problem.
Exactly. Do you think that Walter would have realized how valuable his little brother was if they hadn't been in all that danger?
Mm-hmm.
He would have still thought that he was a problem-causing little brother, right? All right. So we're going to do an activity. I'm going to share what the activity is. It's going to be the same. Oh, and Let me ask you some questions about the two books together before we go to the next team. How are they alike? What are some similarities you see between them?
They went to different places to find out the solution to the first beginning.
All right. Okay. And how else are they alike? What are some other similarities?
At first they have different emotions, and then they find out how something is really valuable.
Okay, all right. First, Max found out that, what did Max find out was valuable?
His mom.
Mm-hmm. And what did Danny find out was in his house? What did Danny find out that was valuable?
His brother.
So Max found out all the comforts of home are important and valuable, and Danny found out that his brother was valuable.
Walter.
All right? Walter, yeah. So, all right. So let me show you what we're going to do. We're going to do exactly what we just did as a whole class, just from each table. All right? And we're going to do that, and we're going to create a presentation. And I'm going to give you a choice between making two books. Now, the iPads on your table give you the directions on how to make these little books. And in a second, I'm going to have you go and select a book for your table. And you can see what I'm asking you. I did one for each book, and there are two different styles. I want you to be able to choose which one you like best. This one is a one-page book, and I'm going to show you how to make that. It's really a pretty easy book to make. It has a title. And then it has the first setting and what's happening, what was going on in the story because of the first setting. And then it has a picture. This one is a picture of Max. And this one says the setting. Max is at home and he's not happy. And this is the second picture of where the wild things are. There's a wild thing swinging on a tree. And the second setting is Max is on an island with the wild things and he realizes that he misses home. Alright? So it says the setting and what's happening with the setting. All right, so that's what I want your book to have. Show them what the two settings were and how they affect the storyline. The second one is an accordion book, like an accordion. And this one is for Zathura. It has the first setting here, and the second setting here, and then a picture in between. The first setting is, at home, the boys are not getting along. And the second setting is, the boys are in space, and Walter realizes how valuable Danny is, okay? So. I'm going to show you how to make the books really quickly, but the iPads show you how to make them also. There's a tutorial on the iPads of how to make them, all right? So, let me show you first how to make them, and then I'll let you choose your book. All right, and I'm going to spread out the art supplies on this staircase over here for you to get them once you're ready to start decorating. So to make the first one, that is a, yes?
Instead of making a book, can you make the one that you can see?
I'm going to do both of them. So that you can see both of them. I'm going to do them really quickly, but the iPad has a tutorial on it, so you can choose which one you think is easier. Fold it in half once. Fold it in half twice. Fold it in half three times. Open it up. On the fold side, do you see how that looks like it's a cross? I'm going to stop before I go all the way down. I'm only going to cut halfway. It's kind of like this. And then when I open it up, I can fold it like a hot dog and then push this together and then fold it flat. And I made a little mini book out of one page without even having to glue or anything onto it, okay? The second one is, I have these pages these papers cut out. And what you're going to do is you're going to get, you will need one piece of tape for the center. And the neater that you do each step, the neater it'll be. All right, so then you already have the fold in the center. Fold it towards the center, and then fold each side down, or fold one, do one side at a time. Fold the first side down. All right. And then fold the outside up to that, and the inside to that center fold. And then do the same thing on the side. Fold that side up. Make sure it goes forward, backwards, forward, backwards, forward, backwards, forwards. Alright? So if you make the folds and then do forward, backwards, accordion. Okay? And the tutorial gives you like an easy step by step for that. Alright, so let me have you choose. What I want you to do is you're gonna do kind of a summary. You're going to identify the two settings in the book, two major settings, and then you're going to tell how they affect the storyline. All right? So, let me have two people from each desk, go and get a book. All right. Okay, so let me tell you what you're going to do. So now that you have the book and you have the iPad, what I want you to do is I want you to divide up into groups at your table, decide who's going to make the book, who's going to read the story, and then while two people are reading the story or one person is reading the story, then the other part of the group is going to get the supplies and start making the book. All right, and then the people that are reading the book are going to direct. The people that Art is going to direct the other people on the table to draw the pictures, the two settings. All right? And then you're also going to have to write down the settings. So you're going to use pictures and words. And I want everyone working, and if somebody's working on the book and the other people want to add drawings to it, you can get scrap paper from over here and you can cut it out and you can glue it onto the book. All right? So no one should be just sitting around, everyone's contributing, and I'm gonna give you about 15 minutes to do this, okay? But I want everyone working. I'm gonna walk around, I'm gonna give you a little bit of help. Now I'm gonna tell you right now, these books, you're easily gonna see some similarities between these two books and the two books that I showed you, all right? You're gonna see some similarities between, so there's a pattern about picking out what the settings are, all right? That's the hint that I'm gonna give you, all right? All right, my friends that are starting to read, start opening up, cracking those books open, and start trying to figure out the two main settings. My friends that are making the book, go get you, decide which one you want to do, and then we'll find the tutorial and start making it.
There is like, first we need to write this
Bob is exploring the beach, then he gets pulled by the lake, then he finds a camera on the shore. Free drawing!
You ready? So, what do you want to say about this?
So, two boys.
The boys don't have eyelashes.
Yes. In real life, they do, but.
Yeah, all people have eyelashes.
Someone's carrying a grocery.
So let's put something up for the second setting, that way you have something on there, and you move back and make sure.
Yeah, so this is the second setting.
Okay. So write something for the second setting.
Yeah, so just need a color. This one's going to do the pufferfish over.
Oh my god, looking really good now.
feel like I wish I
had wouldn't that
dark
bad
dark.
Hard.
I bet this one is like lighter than this one, so that means I need a darker blue.
Is that
a
darker
blue?
Yeah,
you can
have
his clothes.
I need a dark blue.
Here's some extra.
So should I write then he opens the camera box and he finds some pictures.
This is so hard to draw the
should
boy.
Alright, you got about 2 minutes, so
no.
So pace yourself and figure out how fast you have to finish this up, and then we're gonna put it together. Make sure I'm gonna give you about 1 minute to make sure it's put together, and then we're gonna present.
Should I say the boy finds a camera, opens the camera and finds some pictures, then he examines them, and he finds out he finds there's a whole underwater world.
Make it simple. So why don't we just get to the last part?
The boy finds the whole world underwater.
There you go. That's perfect. So that's the second part of the setting.
There we go.
No. He has such a bad head.
Sorry.
Bad
jungle.
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 Your books. I want you to start putting the book together. So start to cut out the pictures and glue them in. Start putting your book together. I'm gonna give you 1 minute to assemble your book.
I'm almost there,
guys.
All right. So go ahead and cut out. Get a pair of scissors.
Remember,
cut out your picture and you're gonna glue it in there. Okay. All right.
Don't rush your
book, anyways.
Matt, I'm anxious.
All right. Looks good.
Okay.
All right. Just start gluing in the pictures, okay? Even if it's not finished.
I have to finish the boy.
Right. It looks good. That's actually pretty awesome. Oh, okay. That's all right. If you have not started gluing, start gluing and cutting now. Pencils down. Start gluing and cutting now. All right, start gluing and cutting now.
Okay, well, I
did it. Start gluing and cutting now. Start gluing and cutting now. Assemble. You're going to have 1 minute to assemble.
1 minute to assemble. I'm ready. He's not good. I know.
We
can
call
it
arrows.
Like,
wait, do we just cut it like?
Go ahead. Yeah, just cut
it's
it.
Good enough.
Cut it to about the size of the square.
I'm in.
We have some skinny legs.
Hey.
Don't criticize. You gotta support your teammates.
No, but I just like
the
legs.
Okay. They're torturing me. His glue is torturing.
Don't over glue it, cause you don't want to glue it shut.
Oh, just to make sure.
All right, then start picking up your supplies.
Water.
All right.
Sure.
All right, so go ahead, yeah. Yeah. And then that one goes on that side.
Yeah, so
all right, crayons down. Go ahead and start gluing them in.
Bin,
we got, you just got 1 minute.
Bin.
Less than a minute. Glue that side in.
Just to make sure they know that he has skin.
Is that
what about your drawings?
Your drawing. Okay, now I'm going to put the color.
Yeah.
My drawing is pretty bad.
Oh, come on, Matt. It's really good. Malik's is all colored.
All right, glue that in. Just a little bit going back.
Wait, did you put the?
Yeah.
You should put it on the front.
No, just.
First page is good. Title page.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome.
Maybe cut like showing it the front.
Clean up your supplies. Push the color back, and then I want you to discuss your book. In the
wait,
discuss your book so that you guys know who to, so anyone can present.
Alright?
So,
skipping our class time.
Wait,
do we put?
So, this is what happens.
Well, wait for your teammates to come back. Put the pencils up. Where's
this one
go?
You can be her teammate.
And Selena, you want to
go? Oh.
Alright, start putting your
Malik
pencils up.
Malik's over here is like pretty good.
Put the finish up because you
got. But Togo would have been easier.
Oh, that's
kind
of
cool.
The boy
is pretty hard to
draw. Yeah, we can.
Togo would have been.
Yeah, because it's a little bit too big.
A little bit of the lava is not like it. I'm gonna put a little bit of the lava.
Are you sure I just can't help?
I want you guys to discuss. I want you to look at the book together and discuss it because you're going to present it.
Alright, so let's just close it. Ready and stuff.
Okay.
Let's just close it.
Wait,
let's just close it. And
all right. Put the crayons up. Put the scissors up. Put the scraps of paper over there. And then I want you to just. I want you to just spend about 1 minute discussing it, and you're going to share with me because I want. I'm going to be able to call to anybody.
Can your presenter be up here?
Present through your table because I want you on the video camera.
Okay, so
guys, sit at the table and discuss it. That's what I want you to do right now. It's time off. This table's coming up. That's fine.
So we have this thing called book that we read called Bossam. It's Bob is exploring.
All right, I want you guys to discuss your book for like 1 minute.
By a wave.
Discuss your book. This book that you made. Discuss it with your chips so that anybody at the table can present. Why don't you, since you wrote the words, And what happened to the
there's a new, the boy finds the picture and he knew that there is an underwater world where animals do very unexpected things.
Alright, excellent. So good explanation of that book and good explanation that you're saying. You guys were very, very good at presenting. I want you to be very good an audience to this table over here. Go ahead and get started. Who is the person that wants to volunteer to explain their book? Do you want to explain, Andrea?
Sure.
All right, tell us what the title is and then show us the two settings.
So the title is for a game, and the setting is the two boys and the parents are carrying groceries and preparing for the hurricane.
Show us the picture. I like that. That's a very nice drawing.
Thank you.
And what's the second setting?
So the second setting is the chain, they imagine jungle, then ocean after this phase. They return to the home.
Alright, so that story, how is that story similar to the two stories that we read? So the setting. Go ahead.
And one, two boys.
All right.
His name was,
like the two brothers?
Yeah.
And the third, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So in this story, he explored an imaginary underwater world. In this story, they used their imagination, right? Mm-hmm. To explore an imaginary world. All right? All right. So what I want us to do now is I want us to think about, what did we talk about today? What did we learn?
How setting makes a big change or twist in the book.
All right, how setting can change the book. All right, and we looked at two books, and then you guys looked at a book on your own, and you guys explained how the setting changed the plot of the book. What I want you to do now is I want you to think about what you did today, and I want you to share with me. Now this is a reflection page, and I see everybody put up their pencils, but I should have told you to hold it. Go get your pencils. But let me go ahead and wait. Let me pass these out, and I'll explain to you what they are, and I'm going to send you back there to get pencils. So what I want you to do is, I want you to reflect about what you learned today on this paper, and I want you to write, the first one is, section you're going to write, what did I do? And the second section you're going to write, what did I learn? All right? So I want to know that you got to answer all the questions really perfectly, but I want to know each individual person what you learned today. So the first part is, what did you do? The second part is, what did you learn? Can we have people from this table? Will you go get actually 3 pencils for people at your table? And will you get 4 pencils for people at your table? Go ahead and work on that. And you guys did a really good job today. writing about what you, writing and reflecting on what you learned is a great way to bring it deep in your memory and really getting a firm understanding of what you just did. And we spent today working on identifying and setting